Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
You know, one of my favorite features of my iPhone 12 is its wireless charging and its MagSafe magnetic back. I was looking for a mount for my car that could hold my phone and charge it at the same time. Luckily for me, my boys over at Carphone Zone hooked it up with a sleek magnetic mount charger. Imagine the look on my friends' faces when I pull out my sexy iPhone 12 and slap that bad boy onto the magnetic mount. And if that's not enough sauce, when they hear that sound and realize that it's also a charger, they look at me like I'm a god. In fact, I love the attention so much, I headed on over to Carphone Zone myself and picked up a leather multifunctional car seat organizer. Now, whenever I pick up a girl for a date, she'll see how organized I am as soon as she hops in the whip. And she'll take a look at that magnetic mount with the fully juiced up iPhone 12. Always ready to go. So go ahead and check out CarphoneZone.com for all your car and phone accessory needs. And Carphone Zone is hooking it up fat. Ricker and Bond listeners get a 15% discount when they use code PODCAST at checkout. That's PODCAST all capital letters. 15% off store wide. And you know they got that free shipping. Don't even play. CarphoneZone.com. Check them out now.
Everybody, it's Ricker and Bond live in your ears and live on your eyes. If you caught it, it's everybody's favorite episode because it's the current one you're listening to, Bond Jen.
Hey everyone, it's me, Bond Jen, back again, your friend. Enjoy the episode. Bye.
Subscribe on Apple Podcasts, follow on Instagram. See us live, Ricker and Bond. Peace.
Bye.
How come you don't want
me?
He did it again, Bonnie.
I have to start off the live with a filter, of course. Hey, everybody.
He did it again, dude.
Who did he do?
The littlest baby.
A small baby.
Little baby. Dundiddly did it again, dude. With a catchy ass song and a lovely, lovely little rap ditty, dude.
And this one sounds only a little bit different than the last one.
It sounds different, dude. There's a different little melody, man. What's going on, man?
What's up?
See, it's already in your head. It's already in your head, man. Ricker and Bond, best podcast on the... It was the universe, was the thing. In-depth, free-flowing conversation about whatever's appropriate at the time. Live on Instagram, live on Clubhouse. Ricker and Bond on Instagram. At Bond on Clubhouse. At Ricker on Clubhouse. Still trying Twitch, man. Twitch done... It got me again.
We're still experimenting again, with the live... going good so far. Shout out to everybody in the live, all two people. Shout out to everybody in Clubhouse, we don't know how many. Shout out to the 14 million people that listen to this episode on Apple and Spotify, and the 50 trillion in other.
Bezos, if you could help me out with your Twitch over there, that'd be good. If you can call Tim real quick and see, maybe get on a conference call with whoever has OBS. It's probably one of you three. Tell me how I can, you know, get some good audio from Zoom. You know, I already downloaded that third-party two-channel audio capturing device on my Mac. It gets my YouTubes, gets my other things, but all I need is my audio from Zoom into that little aggregate thing, multi-output, you know, and then feed that into OBS, man. That's all I need. Is that so hard?
It kind of seems like they don't want us to win.
Yeah, it does seem like they're actively trying to cut us at the knees because they're afraid of the power.
They don't want us to succeed. That's why.
They're afraid of what happens with success, you know?
They're suppressing the pod at 2 views per episode. It's them. They're the ones.
They're not trying to make us fail. They're just scared of what happens when we don't fail. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Absolutely. Welcome everybody to the brand new episode. It's the Wednesday episode.
That's absolutely the tone of people on Clubhouse.
Hey, everybody got absolutely. We're gonna circle back around.
It's like a little better than a conference call on a Zoom call with some employer.
Clubhouse culture.
There's different sections. There's different like cities in Clubhouse. Really,
do you think they made Clubhouse has a collected virtual, bro? Net worth of $50,000 altogether?
But they talk in a way where, as such, they're making something sound like it. You know, it is worth. You know,
what you can't see is them really in the back of Pizza Hut
holding three babies at one time, burping a baby while trying to vacuum like Timmy's mother in Fairly Odd Parents.
Clubhouse. Gosh. It's what's for dinner.
What's going on, dude? What's crack-a-lacking over there in Bondland?
I got off of work really early, and I had a plan to like do so many things, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
You could have
done so many things, dude.
I ate an entire Trader Joe's frozen pizza, and I fell asleep.
Recently I also ate a very big pizza, and it put me out of commission. It didn't allow me to do many things.
It knocks you out so hard, like you're like, damn, was I dead for like a couple minutes or like a couple hours?
I wasn't on my Zoom window. I was kind of looking at Instagram, and then I looked at the Zoom window real quick, and it's a stark difference.
Oh my god,
big pizza. What kind of pizza would you have?
It was the roasted vegetable pizza. Totally recommend. Delicious.
10 out of 10. Nutritious. Would you eat it again?
Yes, I actually did eat it again.
Threw it up?
Yeah.
Ate it again. You've been learning from the cat.
I've been learning. What's going on with you?
Oh, nothing, man. Just another level, another day, you know. Wearing a beanie because my hair is long. And it's really annoying, so I stuff it in a hat. You know, looking like
that. Right. Cut that out.
Eventually, I got the clippers ordered. The peak of when I was just done with it kind of subsided a little bit. So I've forgotten a little bit about the egregiousness of having very long hair after I shove it in a hat. You know.
Yeah.
Just shove it all in there, dude. Too.
Kinda.
It is getting. I see it, dude. You're looking like Donald Glover a little bit.
Starting to look a little Donald, huh? I don't know. Kind of look a little childish.
You kind of look like a werewolf man of sorts.
A little beanie, a little beano.
It looks like you have a defined square on your head.
Yeah, but it's okay. I got the muscles coming in to match. They come in slow.
Yeah.
I'm really proud. I'm really proud of this sculpt. Because it's 100% all natural, no creatine.
I was thinking about creatine recently, you know.
Yeah, it's fucking definitely helpful, but if you don't stay on that shit, you know what can happen.
Would you deflate worse than you would deflate if you were off creatine?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Way faster.
So way faster too. Say you stop working out right now. You're not on creatine, right?
Yeah.
You the amount of muscle you would lose. Would be better off. You'd have more muscle than if you were on creatine and stopped working out cold turkey.
If you were on creatine and stopped working out cold turkey, how do I explain this? So
gotta do a math.
When you're on creatine, and let's say you're working out. Let's say you're working for a month every day.
Yeah.
Maybe take a day off, and you get fucking huge. You get the size you would get in a month that you would get without creatine in like 3 months. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, but it's all water weight. So you got to drink a lot of water to like not die, and not get like.
It's not even
stones.
Muscle, dude. Is it still muscle creatine?
It's still muscle. Like a lot of people like cycle on and off of it. So it's like it's not something that's super taboo, and you're still like strong, you know. But if you stop working out, you lose all of that. Plus, I think you're worse than when you started working out because I always feel smaller than when I started working out when I'm on creatine. Now,
you're on a crutch, you know, like you need some powder to get some gains, you know.
And also, if like I were to stop working out today, I wouldn't lose it as fast, but also like I would still like. not look as small, you know?
Sure.
Like, the muscle will be there for longer. I could probably go, like, 2 months and still look okay. I would definitely look smaller, but, you know, I wouldn't look like I did last summer. That shit was disgusting.
What did you do last summer?
Just not go to the gym for 8 months because of a pandemic.
That was a movie joke. Yeah. Damn, that's last summer. Is it almost a pandemic anniversary? I don't know when you call it.
I think we're about there.
I would call it at the LA lockdown. That was the day.
I think that was like in a couple days.
That was the Weeknd album. I don't know if it was when it debuted or maybe it was just when I listened to it.
The Weeknd album was a little after. Let me grab my charger.
Okay. Yeah. The Weeknd album, latest, for those of you listening in the future, 2021, March, is, what was it? It was called After Hours. Was it called After Hours? I think it was called After Hours, but that was the first time I listened to that album was when the LA lockdown occurred, dude. LA went into lock, and I turned on Able After Hours.
It's way too late. Yep. Save ourselves, baby. Great album. Weird time. Going to the grocery store in a hazmat suit.
Yeah.
Market tanking. Lost 2 jobs in 1 day.
Yeah.
Plus getting evicted. Plus global pandemic. That was a weird time. Kind of kicking myself for not, you know, maybe making a sick documentary, but maybe next time I'll get it.
It would have been a nice little 4 or 5 parter.
Yeah, like definitely the beginning, the scary part.
Yeah. You probably need a little foresight for it, but I mean, I guess you could be like, hey, this is the first time this has happened ever, plus some other events in my life. I think that can make this into at least a nice little series.
God damn, what a weird time.
Would have gotten a nice little handful of views.
Everyone just dipped.
Yeah. Just like globally. Global dipping, dude.
I don't remember what I was thinking back then, but I was like, I would just take walks every day because I didn't have to go to work.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I got this money. I don't know what to do. I'm just going to walk around and just listen to Able.
I didn't go to work because I was like, yo, my guy, you're old. I live with 8 people that smoke chops, go out all the time, and are young. You're probably going to die if I touch you. And I was like, he's like, all right, stay. Don't come here. What did I do?
You went home. We were going to move in that house.
Well, like immediately, there was still some months.
You moved back pretty quick. You definitely moved out like, I want to say like right when lockdown started.
Maybe I went like a to little San before. Diego, and I think I wasn't planning on staying. And then I realized I didn't have money to pay for rent for more than like 6 months.
God damn.
I was about to do that. That would have been bad, dude. It probably would have been all right, but it would have been something.
That's such a weird summer. Like right after that. Like spring was weird. I remember during the lockdown, there was a couple days when it was just pouring rain.
I don't know.
And I was like, what the fuck do I do?
I remember I did go to San Diego hella quick because I thought I would just get touched with a COVID real quick. Like, I was trying to thwart that a little bit.
I kind of was never afraid of getting COVID. I mean, yeah. I was kind of afraid, but I wasn't like, you know, but you never know.
Never knew. Do you got some family members with the vax in their arm now, dude?
Damn, they got chipped. Put the chip in me, Mr. Zuckerberg.
I don't think I ever sent you there's a funny comedian video of Duncan Trussell as a comedian. He had a, did I explain this last time?
No.
He had a story and he was getting a vaccine at a church and he got shot up and then he was like, oh my God, I can't see my vision. And you're like, no, I'm just kidding.
Oh yeah. You did say that.
Yeah. It was a funny thing.
What an asshole. What a dick. I actually lost my vision.
He did it.
I got vaccinated.
Did it jovially, dude.
Also watch my show.
Huh?
He has. What if he said, also watch my show?
How is that show doing? Is it dead yet?
I think they're like in between seasons. I haven't heard
Duncan Trussell's, what's it called?
The Midnight Gospel.
Midnight Gospel by the Duncan Trussell, dude. Duncan Trussell moved out of LA. He's in like Colorado or something.
I have some news about my venture.
Of what?
YouTube.
Okay, okay. How's your Fiverr going?
So, remember I said I was going to raise capital?
Yes.
I changed my mind. I just said, fuck it, I'll fund it myself.
Sure.
What changed my mind was I was talking to my good friend, neighbor Jeff, because I was trying to get him on it. And something about the conversation just made me like so turned off to having anyone else involved.
Well, that is the deal with getting funded by other people.
What was part of the conversation? Well, whenever we talk about money or something like that, he gets like so serious so fast, and I'm just like,
serious Jeff, dude. Serious Jeff definitely exudes an energy.
Yeah, I'm like, dude, it's like, what, a couple hundred bucks, dude? Jesus.
And it could have been a nice exercise, though. But how'd it go down?
Well, he really wanted 50%, and I was like, not going to happen, first of all, you know, because if this blows up, I'm going to fucking kill myself if I'm giving you half of it. And I know I'm going to be doing most of the work. Yeah. So, and I just got to thinking, you know what? Fuck it. And then I thought about changing. I'm gonna change the niche that I'm in, because I read that there's like these thing that like makes it harder to monetize videos for children on YouTube. So I'm gonna change the direction of my channel. And I already like found the outsource person, already paid him, already put in the order. Not gonna disclose the niche on the air. I'll tell you, like, you know, on the break or something, so I don't want anyone to steal it. But yeah, that's where I'm at. It's gonna take like a month to get the shit, so now I'm just sitting on my ass.
A big old batch of stuff.
Big batch, fat nice. Batch.
Nice, nice, nice.
And yeah, we'll see. I think it'll work for. It'll be good for YouTube, TikTok, definitely TikTok. And I'm thinking Facebook too. I think this shit could go big on Facebook.
Interesting.
So I'm going to give that a try.
I have one guess so far, but I don't think that'll work for outsourcing, so maybe not that guess. We 20-ish? Yeah.
We are 16.
Okay.
Yeah, I ordered it a couple days ago, and then I was thinking, at first he told me, okay, it's going to take a month to get it. And I was like, all right. And then I got thinking like, okay, what if this works? And then I only have 25 videos, and then I have to wait another month to get another video. So I hit him up. I was like, bro, dog, double my order. And he was like, okay, now that you're ordering this much, I'm going to double speed your order. And I was like, for sure, dog.
Nice.
So we'll see. Keep you updated on that.
Nice, 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 dude. YouTube.
Yup tub. They still paying as long as you're not swearing in your videos.
They give money. As long as you get some traction to it.
Yes. It also depends on what you talk about. CPM is different for niches.
Really?
The highest paying apparently is if you're talking about finance or investing. You make the most money for the least amount of views, because advertisers pay more, I guess.
It makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, I don't know what the least paying is, but yeah, that's the highest
paying. What would advertisers pay the least for? Probably like meme stuff, super like saturated. iDubbbz, dude.
Yeah. Or like maybe
Shane Dawson stuff.
Like maybe even stuff. Video games, because there's so many like gaming channels and shit.
Yeah, but if you're on the upper end of that, then you got a lot of people in it, audience wise.
Yeah, but like since there's so many, you know, there's like it's kind of cheap. Meanwhile, finance, there's like it's kind of still small because not a lot of people know a lot about like banks and shit. And so Wells Fargo's like, bam, here, bank with us.
Money, Square, dude. Freaking, Square. What's it called? SoFi. SoFi with a centralized joint. PayPal. Yeah. PayPal doing some crypto stuff.
PayPal going hard on the crypto. Cash App, I found today, they have a debit card. I have that. I've had it for a while. But you can put, like, rewards on it. And they have one where you get 10% of your purchase back in Bitcoin, up to $7.50 if you eat at a restaurant.
Up to $7?
Yes, you get $7 worth of Bitcoin. But you would need to eat $700 worth of food to get $7 of Bitcoin. So you get a couple cents of Bitcoin, you know.
Eat out a lot, or if you're, you know, already balling to like restaurants a lot, and you're like, hey, a little Bitcoin out of it.
Little Bitcoin action. So yeah, little, that's my business first dinners, experience dude, if with you're, Bitcoin. Is,
what did you say? No, please, by all means, you.
I don't even know what I'm saying.
Your first experience with Bitcoin?
Oh, my first experience with Bitcoin rewards.
Still haven't looked up staking like I need to. Kind of just waiting for Coinbase to be like, hey, while you're Ethereum, you can stake it right now with us. And I'll be like, oh, shit, dude. Want to do that? Will do that. And I want you to give me money for it, Coinbase. Coinbase IPOing soon. Roblox, are you up on the Roblox? No, not it's a kid all. Thing. It's a little kid thing. I don't know what it is, but apparently everybody likes it and it's IPOing. So.
All right. We'll be back.
Second trimester. See you later.
See you later.
Yo, shut the fuck up. Yo, we finally
now. Welcome to my chill YouTube playlist.
Yeah, yeah. Welcome to the chill house. It's the chillest.
It's welcome the chillest. Everybody on Instagram, on Clubhouse, not on Twitch yet. Not on Twitch yet. Step closer than last time. I really want to be on there, dude. It'll be so nice.
Someday the Lord will
subscriptions. People asking us questions. If anybody does have questions on Instagram, and not on Clubhouse, click the little question mark thing. And if you're listening to this podcast in the future, we are on Instagram every time we record it on Sunday, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Sunday, 11 a.m. Pacific, usually. Tuesday and Thursday, 5 p.m. Pacific, usually.
I know that's a lot to digest, so just turn on notifications.
You're going to want to turn on Instagram notifications.
Yes.
There's a lot of memes and a lot of funny funnies. But the real meat and potatoes of it, which means you get that real sustenance, is when Ricker and Bond goes live every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. You know, it's about to go down, dude.
Amen. Amen.
And also after Sunday's recording, we do live church. We are ordained pastors. So I'm also kind of Rastafarian. Well,
it's almost time married for the into it. Demiversary.
It's almost the pandemiversary, which coincides every year with the podversary. And that's coming up in like a week.
Oh, God. We got cake.
There's cake. And it's going to say, you didn't die. Thank you.
You made it through. We're going to be at Alameda Strip Club throwing down next Thursday. You're invited. Everybody is invited to Ricker and Bond Season 4 Extravaganza. It's going to be fucking lit, bitch.
We're the ones that are stripping on the pole.
Yes. Come on through. Best tacos in fucking wherever that place is. Southeast LA. Deep Southeast LA.
I've never been to such a stylish. Never been to the establishment.
can't even hear the music at the strip club because the railroad's so loud.
Oh, yeah? I'm a fan of trains. I enjoy trains every now and again.
Yeah. Yeah. It's great. Bring cash. Don't use their ATM. They fucking rob you.
They take Bitcoin, Ethereum?
They do not. They only take that depreciating IOU note.
Wow.
What's going on? The market's up today.
Correction,
I'm going to stop perioding myself.
It is, dude, it's funny that people that were into investing very hard after the crash, the only thing they knew was up, dude. And a little correction, it's like, yo, dude, this is, why is the market acting weird, dude? What's going on?
Yes.
That was everybody's first little taste that are watching whatever that one dude, that one Ben Shapiro dude on YouTube. This is, you know, I think that's how it works a little bit. Every month you got a little red ski, dude, and green all the time.
Sometimes you gotta taste the dirt to appreciate the air.
And appreciate the dirt. Which after, means get that dirt low price and make it go up, dude.
It might not be over. Let's not get
I'm
too
actually,
get
I'm
too
actually
cocky.
Guessing that March gets a little lower. From what I've researched, meaning what other people have researched, and I've listened to them talk about it, March is usually kind of low performing towards the end of the month.
I hope so.
So do I.
so I can fucking get some deals because I didn't have cash.
Yeah. Yeah, as do I.
Literally, I was like, yo, Apple looking so tasty right now.
It's close to a nice little 200 moving average, dude.
Oh, God.
You're definitely welcome for the recognition.
A couple shares of that for sure.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, I might have to get a non-ARK ETF. I might have to get an actual like index fund.
How about a little bit of a Vanguard Total Stock Market, VTI?
Looking at that little VOO, the little QQQ. I also noticed that I'm super all the way into tech. So when tech is kind of not doing super great, yeah, I see that.
Yeah, I kind of only care about tech, so.
Yeah, yeah. I think
you won't see me throwing any money at Walmart or Home Depot anytime soon.
It's, you know, I gotta, you know, maybe a couple years after I'm done sucking tech dry, I'll do a little more good percentages of everything here and there so I can, you know, have a nice circle. But for now, dude, for now, if it has a chip, bro, and if it has people thinking about the future, I'm in it hard.
Yeah, like
I need a little index fund though. I need an index fund. Because at the beginning, when I was setting up my core positions, I kind of confused ARK. It's an ETF. It's a actively traded, but I kind of thought like, oh, this has like everything in the market. It kind of does, but it's basically just tech stuff and very not stuff now in the market. So.
Oh yeah. So that shit's going to shoot up in the summer.
Maybe.
Because, as you know, our good friend Kathy likes to do, when shit goes down, she doubles down.
She does.
So she does. Why does my phone keep fucking turning off?
Maybe because you're out of battery.
When I'm obviously Instagram living.
Maybe it's because you're using filters.
That makes no sense. I'm plugged in.
I don't know.
That is like zero sense. It should stay on.
Try without the filter.
Never.
The filter just constantly tracking your positions and trying to figure out where you are.
Why would the filter affect the connect? Like why my phone stays on or not?
Maybe a lot of usage of the phone. You got a little Clubhouse going on. Mine went black for a little bit as well. What's going on, Tiffany Brooks?
This is an iPhone 12. Plugged in. I don't know. Maybe it needs more juice. But yeah, that's weird. Fix it, Tim.
Tim Cookie, dude.
Also, make it so that you can unlock your phone with your mask on. That would be cool.
Maybe it's a little short-sighted.
It's actually coming soon.
Do they do this thing with glasses? I think in the past, sunglasses got in the way.
Yeah, glasses work now. Beards work now.
They didn't have beards ready?
No, beards, I think, were
like if you grew
good.
A beard?
Yeah.
That kind of makes sense. But like, damn, they didn't have that ready?
No, I was ready. Glasses were ready too, but what wasn't ready was masks.
Mm.
but that should be coming in a couple of weeks, apparently. So,
everybody with those edgy Chinese masks that are cool and kawaii are going to be able to open their phones?
The pandemic's going to be over, and they're going to be like, hey, now you can open it with a mask.
That's why I said the edgy kids who were super into the mask before are, you know, your Scar Lords, your Chinese people at the U of A, your other hyper pop people, bro. Dude, I was on Twitch. Yes. The only time I really do music on Twitch now is the weekends, and you get people in for feedback. And this one person, do you know what hyper pop is?
No.
It's kind of like Playboi Carti, but like even more so than kind of like high pitched and like weird, annoyingly like that. Even more so than that, Playboi Carti's not like even hyper pop, but it's kind of like that. Like, you know, like Gex person, 100 Gex or something. I don't even know if that's true. I don't think I've listened to them, but it was all that high pitched voices and like weird pop, screechy production. And I first gave some kind of like technical analysis of like, all right, this, you know, there's this and the kind of like technical stuff. But then I was like, also, I hate the hell out of this. Personally, I think it's trash, and I'm definitely not your audience. And usually people are like, I kind of like laugh that off and like, oh, that's kind of funny. You're very abrupt and like truthful abrasively. But this guy was like, you're a hater for real. And I'm like, whoa, bro. It's the first time ever anybody called me a hater, bro. What's up with that?
You're a hater for real, bro.
he said, you, letter U, A, hater, F-R. That just made me laugh so hard.
You probably broke his heart. You're a hater for real. Like 17.
Yeah, he is. I was like, but I say, like, I'm definitely not your audience, so, like, I'm not the best sample size, you know?
Maybe you could have kept it to yourself?
No, my whole thing is, like, if I think something's trash, I'm going to be like, yo, I would definitely wouldn't bump this in my playlist, sure. But yeah, okay. I give them...
He's going to kill himself.
Bro, if he can... Because usually, that was literally the only person in my career of Twitching that got, like, butt hurt. Maybe besides, like, two or three other people. And there's a lot of people that go, that kind of come in for feedback. And usually they're like, haha, that's funny. But, like, thanks for being truthful. This guy, dude. This guy. You a hater for real.
You're a hater disgusting. For real.
You a hater FR, dude. Just made me laugh. And someone else that, like, frequented was in there. And that's where I kind of got the Simon Cowell emoji from. I still got to make that. But I was like, dude, you're like, come on, bro.
You gotta admit, you are a hater for real.
I didn't hate on it, dude. I said, I think this is trash and I wouldn't listen to it, but I'm not your audience. Is that hating? Or is that being in touch with myself?
You said it was trash. You could have just said it. Like, just because you don't like it doesn't mean it's trash.
That's what I said. I said, I'm not your audience, so I don't know, you know? I don't even know if I said it was trash. I might have just been like, I don't like it. Or I was like, yeah, this sucks.
This made my grandmother go deaf.
It would literally make old people probably screech. It's a weird like new music for the high frequency.
Is there a way to save this filter? Because this is a fucking a bitchin' filter right here.
I think the more you use something, the more it pops up. Perhaps I'm not
Neon
sure.
Frames 3.
If anybody's wondering, listening to the podcast, we just have a super old teen navigating through Instagram filters.
I'm super old. With the dark foreground and the neon, it looks pretty sick.
It's all right. It looks okay. Again, if you want to be into this live experience, this super cool experience, you're going to want to go to adobehouse.live/crypto. First, give us all your Ethereum, and then you're able to go into the Instagram live.
All your Doge as well. We 1,000 Doge.
You could give your Doge to the person after the ampersand. I'll take your Ether.
I'll definitely take the Doge, and I will end up the wealthiest person because there are
still rumblings of people speculating on the upwardness of Doge.
Yeah, I mean, if it got to 5, why can't it get to 10?
You know, this is true. If it can go up, a Doge coin, if a Doge coin goes up, then it can literally go up more.
Yeah.
Especially it's not backed by any science, not backed by any people using it for anything besides trading for yields.
Today, Robinhood tweeted something like against Asian hate. They're like, yo, we're against racism of any kind. And everyone just responded, we don't give a fuck. Just give us the keys to our crypto wallets.
Robin Hood, bro.
Yeah, we don't give a shit. Who gives a fuck if our brokerage is like, anti-racist? All right, guys, give us our chill, fucking money.
Bro. Chill, we understand you're a company, but nah, not us, bro.
Dude, like, why do companies even need to do that, bro? It's so, I get like, it. Everyone can tell.
It's playing to your audience. So if you got a lot of people that are on a specific trend in culture right now, which is Asian hate. I saw a couple things. I'm not a fan of it, dude. You know, actually...
Yeah, I'm glad Robin had put out that statement, because until I saw that tweet, I thought they were racist. I thought they were
specifically against Asians. I was like, yeah, something about this Doge Bitcoin and Ethereum, I get a tinge of Asian racism.
Yeah.
And I was right.
I mean, fuck, unless a company comes out and says, yo... fuck a certain group of people, I'm gonna give them my money, probably.
I would usually assume that they're not on it.
Oh man,
it's funny that the assumption is that, like, yo, if you don't say anything, bro, you hate Asians.
Yeah, that's usually actually, that's how it is.
You they're have just to a say, company and they're just making stuff, but yeah.
Oh, the fucking trend over the summer was, if you don't say you're anti-racist, you're racist.
Yeah,
that, which I thought was bullshit.
Sure.
Like, why do you have to say it? Just don't be racist.
The assumption switched.
It's all a cry for help. I don't know.
Usually, I would assume... I remember, dude, I think I was on an episode with Dorian one time, and there was something said, and it was like... I don't know. It probably, like, it could have alluded to racism. And he was like, you should probably say you're not racist, bro. And I was like, why?
Fuck he's like, that.
Well, I mean, it kind of made a point, but I was like, I just, from my perspective, I'm so assumedly pure in it all, and there's no hate in my body where I just assume everybody's like, obviously, does. And from my perspective outwards, there's no malice in anything, but people inwards putting malice on it could see it.
What did you say?
I forget. The actual phrase.
F-N words or what?
No, it wasn't.
I'll probably say I'm not racist after
that. You know, when you put it that way, it does sound a little bit racist. It did. Yeah, okay.
Like what I thought it. It wasn't racist when I said
it. I said it out loud, deep LA. Everybody looked at me. I started to get beaten up. I was like, hold up a minute. Okay.
This might not be
okay. I understand, dude. Finally, dude, the switch clicked for me. And I was like, okay. Don't be racist. I was like, all right, dude, finally.
Did you see that thing? It was like a headline. It said, like, Papa John is actively working not to say the N-word.
I saw a clip of it. It was. I still don't recall what it was in the past, but I believe his phrasing was, it took an allotted amount of time and effort to get the N-word out of his vocabulary. Just like deep massaging of like, that's not cool.
How frequently do you have to use that word for it to be that big of an issue?
And with no friction, too. With no friction, dude. You got to be around certain people. And that's what you would assume. Be like, you know, and that's where you got some people being like, you got to be anti-racist. If you're around people doing racist stuff, then I would be like, all right, you got to be around some anti-racist people, dude. It's extremes, you know. If you're an extreme racy dude, you should probably get on the other end of the spectrum.
Oh my god. Let's assume none of it's true. How does this controversy start?
I think he did weird stuff. No, there was a call. He said the internet.
Oh, yeah.
He did.
I thought it was like, he was like, oh, this...
I think he might have...
This Black Lives Matter stuff is hurting my pizza sales or something.
No. What it might have been, and this is not based off anything but a very foggy memory, and it's probably wrong. He might have just brought up the word as saying it as a word. Might have been another company that did that as well. It might have not been Papa John. I might be giving Papa John a little bit too much benefit of the doubt. And it probably could also skew the truth that he just does say the N-word a lot.
Oh, God. I could go for some Papa John's right now.
We got a comment on such matter. If everyone watched Drunk History more, no one could be racist. They canceled Drunk History, so I don't know. They canceled it right alongside Tosh.0, dude.
Wow.
I know. Tosh.0, bro. Hell of a run, Tosh.0. Hell of a run.
A little too long of a run.
I mean, if you're in it, dude, it can never go as long. Honestly, he probably was like, this is getting a little long, and I kind of don't want to do this very frequently much more. But he got that money, bro.
I yearn for more out of life than making poop jokes.
He did it well, though, dude. I didn't watch like any of it after like a couple seasons. Because the first couple seasons, I was in goddamn near middle school or something.
Yeah.
And so I watched it, but like, he didn't get super hokey with it. It was still kind of like fun Daniel Tosh humor, you know? And there's only so much you can do with internet videos. And I think he did it well.
Yeah, RIP Daniel Tosh.
Rest in peace, bro. He was good. Racist as hell, bro. Yeah. You know? I think he's married to an Asian.
Oh no.
In this climate, bro?
In this times? Jesus.
When's the last time you had a special, bro? Tosh is good, bro. Those first couple specials, bro. Did you watch those?
No.
They were good.
So, maybe. Maybe they were on in the living room in college.
They were tight.
Slid onto the dirty couch with the dirty table.
More of a 25th thing, probably. How's Miles doing? How's the 25th gang doing?
I actually saw them. I came home from Mexico on Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
Hung out with some buddies at the apartment. Went outside. Got promptly locked out of my apartment.
Oh, no.
Hit up Miles. He said, yo, we're at Brittany's getting trashed. It's her birthday. Yeah. So I drove there. Got trashed with the whole crew.
Yeah.
Miles, Sean, Zach, Triangle Rob, Brittany.
Any Ariettas?
Matt did slide in later, yes.
Okay. You gotta have an area in there.
Drove me to McDonald's.
Nice.
And yeah, they're all doing good.
Good. I'm glad.
Everyone's chilling. They all look exhausted as hell.
Oh, no. I did hit up Sean Lee, and I was like, how are you doing? He was like, I am kind of exhausted from my work. And I was like, damn.
Yeah, he works quite a bit.
Does he?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Get paid for it.
You get paid for it, but you know.
At what cost, you know?
At what cost? Just the time,
being able to pay your rent.
Mental.
Yes, yes.
You know, I had the only issue I have nowadays is, fuck, do I want to go to the gym in Paris or do I want to go to the gym in Italy?
Sure. I mean, the travel time does kind of take away from the workout time. It's kind of like a one-off thing.
I'm just eating breakfast
thing.
On the PJ.
On the...
I don't know. I read about fucking... I'll talk to you about next trimester. But fuck this goddamn iPhone for fucking closing.
I would try
mid-life.
To take the filter off.
I can't do it. It looks too cool.
I would try to take the filter off. Third trimester
I
coming up,
I can't see
everybody.
How that would ever work.
And if you want to see that filter, Instagram Ricker and Bond. Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday. The day before the podcasts come out. And if you don't know, they come out Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Good day. Have a good trimester, second. And we'll see you in the third one.
Dude. Yeah. New Ricker and Bond.
Yo, shut the fuck up. Ricker and Bond.
Everybody don't need
Bond.
Did it again.
It's such a good time.
Everybody's favorite band that they know off top. High Five.
High Five, more like High Four.
They had a cool logo. Kind of looks like the UGK logo, like a collegiate emblem. They had nice high cuts too. I'm looking at Zoom and not the Instagram, and I don't see a filter, and I just felt an overwhelming rush of peace.
An overwhelming what? Rush of what?
Rush of peace, dude.
Damn, you really don't like the filter.
I'm a little against it, dude.
I'm convinced that's the reason people are staying, because they're like, oh, wow, what is that? I'm going to listen to what this guy's saying because he has a cool filter on.
Instagram, Rick Rambon. If anybody is joining in the third trimester and hasn't heard the shout-outs of the Instagram before, us on Clubhouse, at Bon, at Rick, are going to figure out how to do a group in there. Not on Twitch yet. Twitch hasn't been fulfilled. I know you've heard this already 2 times since you're listening to the episode, but I shall conquer Twitch if it's the last thing me and Jeff Bezos do.
They're just making it extra hard on purpose to keep the millennials out.
Apple doesn't want to help Amazon.
Apple
Twitch should have their own. You might have brought it up before, but they should have their own streaming platform. Did you bring that up before?
Apple?
Twitch.
Yeah,
you brought it up with Zoom, but Twitch definitely should.
I don't. It's like so easy. Like what? Dude? And OBS sucks ass, dude. OBS is trash.
Try Streamlabs OBS a little bit better. I realized that recently. I think they actually, it might have been a very, very new version of Streamlabs that they're releasing for the Mac, because before that black one is the only one that I could use. But the one that's green and has eyes with the Streamlabs OBS, which might be different, or just like an offshoot of it, much, much better. Except I still can't get this Zoom audio through it.
I think that's just a Mac issue in general.
It is a Mac thing. They're like, yo, we don't have sound devices in this, so suck it. Soundflower? No, Soundflower is PC, no? Or is it Mac?
Never heard of it.
What's going on, everybody, in the Instagram? 3BDF. Lucid, what's going on? You wonder what?
I don't know if that would work.
What well, if you, let's hash it out like it's a tag, huh?
Like what if you like went out of the computer with a quarter inch into the Scarlet, back out? I don't know. It's just too much. I don't know. I don't think it would work. I just got Amazon PTSD.
Well, dude, I can get the desktop audio, right? I can use that through whatever little app I'm using, but I can't get the Zoom to work on it. I can get YouTube to play on it. You know?
That's weird.
I can't get Zoom, and I think that's a Zoom thing as well. I got through Mac's thing, but I need to get through Zoom's thing. They don't want me to win, but I will.
They don't want you to win, dude. They don't care about
it. I plow through them, bro. Like it's a snow plow, and it's February in New York, bro. Snowing.
Fuck them. Who needs them?
I would like to use their services.
Yeah,
just a little just less like friction.
Fucking Amazon, they don't want you to sell on there. They make it hard as fuck.
They don't make it that hard.
So hard. Like, what the fuck is a UPC code, huh? What the fuck is that shit?
It's the thing that identifies a product.
I gotta get that too.
You do gotta get that. You do gotta get that. You gotta buy that on your own.
That's
they could lame, make it a little Jeff. Bit easier. They could. They could.
Jeff, and you're taking
no. They 40%? Make UPC for you, bro.
Do they?
Maybe.
I don't know. I haven't done it in a while.
FBA was fun, dude. If you have a solid FBA that you can churn through, it's a solid little thing. Sure, they take 50%, but...
I'm not a huge fan of that.
FBA? Which yes. means filled by Amazon, for those of you that are unaware. Give them your products, you give them 50%, and they ship it. You still got to receive the product unless you're doing like a weird little drop ship thing, which I haven't tried with FBA, just getting products directly to me. But
when I'm balling, I'm just going to be like, I can't wait to just have an idea and just be like, somebody do it.
Sure.
Like, just do it. Here's $2,000. set up an Amazon store, sell this, do all the SEO, just here. Yeah, 2 weeks. Enjoy, you know? Because people are really fucking good at stuff. And I'm like, the older I get, I don't have time to learn new things, you know? I'm just going to focus on what I'm good at.
And, party.
You know, just outsource. You know, there's this quote. I read this quote. And
tell me the quote.
I don't know who said it. Maybe Warren Buffett. Maybe Elton John. Someone said it. It said, work on your business, not in your business.
Oh, yeah. There was a lot of business things I was listening to while doing work for FBA, someone else's FBA. And, you know, that's the kind of hump you got to get over with a small business. You got a business going. And if you're working inside of it, you're never going to be able to scale it up.
Yeah, it's difficult.
There's the classic pie scenario. The woman who has a pie company, pie business, brick and mortars, making pies all day, dude. She insists that only I can make the pies this way, and only I have a love for the pies, so much so that I can make it well, which is a good argument. I think I saw Gary Vee post something that was like, obviously, I'm not going to expect employees to care about my company as much as I do because it's my company. And I agree with that. But if you have a business, you can't be so entrenched in it that it doesn't grow if that's your goal with it.
Yeah. I concur. I concur that animation was a prime example because while someone else was doing it, and how much did that cost us? Like 100 and something bucks.
Mm-hmm. We enjoyed the product. We were doing other things.
Yeah, it was way better than anything I would have made in way less time.
Yeah.
And you and I probably made a lot more money than we spent on that in the 2 weeks we were waiting for it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So
that's how we got a little down, but
also, did you get the second revision?
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't respond. Yeah, it's cool. I can see what the face cuts. Chilling.
It's good enough. Thanks, dude. Thanks, person on Fiverr. Gotta talk about Fiverr. Fiverr, not a sponsor, but should be a sponsor. Could be a sponsor.
Might be.
Can you be a sponsor?
Hit them up.
I love it. I've just been looking around at what things people can do. Bro, you can get a full-ass script writer on that shit that'll like do research and shit for you. And I'm just like, bro, dog, that's like a lot of work. Mm-hmm. That for like $20 someone will just do.
I feel like someone could make a cooler website than Fiverr. It seems like Etsy.
It's a little Etsy-ish. There's other websites too, like Upwork and something work. I don't really look too much into those, but
still think there could be a nice one. I'm trying to think of a parallel app that is really, man, I feel like in the future apps will just be so much nicer.
What I don't know,
apps just in general.
Oh yeah, they're definitely
websites.
Gonna. I don't know. They're gonna be different. Smartphones days are numbered for sure.
You said what's numbered?
Smartphone.
Smartphone apps or smartphone itself?
Smartphone itself. Word on the street is 2020. Two or 2023 mixed reality headset from our pals over at Apple.
Oh yeah.
2025 Apple glasses.
Oh yeah. 2035 oh, yeah. Chinese takeover of biggest economy in the world.
Yeah,
that's fun, dude. I'm already looking at Chinese ETFs. What's going on, man?
China going crazy. You know they make like, what was it? Watching some shit.
Whole lot of cash.
It's like,
dude.
One billionaire every 2 months.
A whole lot of cash. And they're like, yo, we need to be giving cash to other people because we have too much, bro.
They were a third world country in the
70s. Or they needed cash or something. One of the two. They have a very surplus of something. I think product, probably. Churning stuff out.
Nuts over there.
Yeah, yeah.
I just read about the world's richest person in history.
Mm-hmm.
Black guy.
Mm-hmm.
Named Mansa Musa, king in the 1300s in Africa. He
sounds familiar.
Controlled much of Africa's gold supply, and he was very, very cool and generous. Supported science and the arts, and architecture.
Not into slave trade?
He definitely had slaves, for sure. Mm. But he was...
But did he trade them?
I don't know. I'm not sure. There's a story where he went on a pilgrimage, and he took like 60,000 men with him, 12,000 slaves, and each of the slaves had like 4 pounds of gold in their fucking pockets, because, you know, he was just balling like that. And he would like go through these villages and just pass out gold to people, and he gave out so much gold that he inflated like the fucking price of shit. So when he came back through, he had to like take most of his gold back.
Higher price.
Yeah,
it was like classic option failure.
I just think that's, imagine controlling that many people, just fucking. And he would do this thing where, like, I think his dad fucking died or something, because he went to go like explore the Atlantic Ocean or some shit.
What part of the world?
This was in Africa, which is
part of Africa.
It's what's now 4 countries, and one of them is Senegal, so wherever that is,
for sure.
He would casually be like, yeah, he grabbed 100,000 men and went to go explore the Atlantic. I'm just like, oh, what'd he find, bro? Didn't find much. It's a whole lot of water.
How'd he fall?
How did he fall? I didn't get to his death yet, but...
It usually ends with death, huh? You really have to kill someone back then.
But he's just super not poor. His net worth is estimated to be $400 billion.
Where are the Saudis at right now with that, dude? I'm sure some Saudis are the richest right now. They got some oil that they're not putting on the books, bro.
I wonder who is definitively the richest individual living right now.
What do you mean definitively? Do you mean legally?
No, I mean like, because, you know, there's always a high truth that we don't know. There is one person living today that has access to the most resources in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And who knows who that fucking can be? They're certainly not on Forbes, because why would you want to? If you're the richest person, you want to keep that shit a secret. So, but, you know, it's probably some Saudi person or some shit.
It's kind of my guess.
Definitely someone in, like, Africa or the Middle East or something weird.
You got to have sand around, bro. You got to be hot.
Probably just laugh at Bezos as well.
Sun blazing down on you.
Just.
I'm sure they are. I'm sure.
Your slaves are just carrying gold in their pockets. That's how rich you are.
Mm. 2021 or 13th century? 1200s, bro. 1200s, dude. I wonder what kind of colors they had.
That wasn't even that long ago.
Not at all.
That was like after Jesus.
Hello. It's probably...
Yeah.
It is closer to Jesus, closer to us than Jesus. If they even got the years right, dude. They really start that at zero, dude, because of a figure? Come on now.
I don't know why. Wasn't it like...
It was actually something else. It's not Jesus.
The king like started... It was like the king was like, yo, we're going to start it on this day. King George, I
BCE.
Believe.
BCE. I learned history class, BC and BCE were the actual things.
What if Jesus was just a dick?
Maybe.
Probably.
Maybe. Think that probably would be cool or not?
I mean, if he was, it doesn't matter, because, like, he's dead. There's literally no way, unless a scroll comes up and says, yo, Jesus was like literally such a cock. And then another one came up in like ancient China that was like, yo, Jesus came and visited us and he was indeed a cock. that would
just written out in Sanskrit.
Yeah. God, imagine reading the scrolls of fucking those cities that guy went through. Like, yo, this king just came by and just gave us a bunch of gold and was just like dripping in bitches.
Some ancient Yiddish, nice. Dude. Mansa Musa. I feel like I've learned about him. Cool name. Would you name a kid Mansa or Musa?
Probably both.
Mansa Musa?
My two sons.
Mm. Would you name one son Mansa Musa and the other Musa Mansa?
Maybe one Mansa and one Musa.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe just one Mansa Musa.
Mm. Hyphenated or like first name, middle name?
First name, middle name.
Mm. You know, that's the easy way out, dude. You're taking the easy road. You got the hyphen.
He would have to be fucking just swaggy as fuck with a name.
Sure,
like
sure,
that.
Sure. Very dark too. Got to be dark.
Definitely gotta be balling on the court or something.
Has to be like balls. Just
have a cool ass dad.
Sure.
You know.
They're doing something in high school. You know what overtime is? It's like a publication for schools or something, or sports. Mm-hmm. And they're giving the high school age basketball players allegedly $100,000 and giving them some like kind of structure with like classes and like financial literacy, essentially overstepping the collegiate sports and being like, yo, we're going to get you paid into the league. And we're also going to give you some schooling as well. But that good schooling. Not history 102.
Stop 100 grand in checking.
Huh? Yeah, yeah.
They're just going to be like, have fun. And it's gone the next week.
I mean, apparently some of these kids have a very big social media following anyways. So you might have some brand deals already. And if you're like the top high school player, I'm sure your parents might have a little say in your accounts.
I can't imagine having a kid that's just like raking in racks on TikTok just for dancing or some shit.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Your kid's making 80 grand a month. Like, what do you fucking do? Like, especially if TikTok, you're a dick to the kid and they're like, ah, fuck you, dad.
You kind of lucked into it. Like, if you look into TikTok a little bit, not even luck, but you're like, you're just doing content and you do it a lot. And you're kind of just like waddling your way into a lump sum. It's kind of like, damn, dude. Like, what if their parents, there's like, they're not the Beverly Hills parents. They're just some middle class folk. And your kid's like, all right, dude. But then you're like, all right, now you got to get some literacy into you.
Yeah. TikTok is like the only social network that like wants you to fucking blow up. All these other apps just like work against you. But TikTok's like, hey, you're fat? Boom. You look a little weird? Boom.
We got an audience for you, dude.
That is kind of weird, bro.
It seems like Instagram, right? It pushes an algorithm of like kind of like generically hot people. It's my assumption that that's what pops up to Instagram, right? I haven't had just like kind of a weird edgelord pop up on my Instagram ever. But on TikTok, I got all sizes, all kind of flavors, all kinds of different flavor content too.
Yeah, TikTok is very open. I was listening to a podcast on it and how it's like literally dicking Instagram right now. Mm-hmm. Like literally a couple billion users away from passing it in monthly users, or a million users away.
Pulling a Disney Plus, dude.
And Mark Zuckerberg has tried to copy it 3 times with no success. Lasso, Clips, Reels.
Reels doing all right. Reels, at least they copied whatever TikTok was doing as pushing the hell out of it number-wise.
But still, most of the Reels are just TikTok re-uploads.
Especially on Ricker and Barnett, it's all TikTok re-uploads. Is this correct?
So, yeah. Mark's not doing too hot with that.
No.
He can't buy it because it's owned by a Chinese conglomerate.
You get the U.S. portion?
I don't know why he didn't try to buy that. There must have been a reason. Probably because Facebook was already under antitrust scrutiny.
Mm.
And Microsoft looks pretty clean in the eyes of the U.S. Gov.
Not in the eyes of that stock market, dude.
Definitely not.
Microsoft, the big boy.
Just
Disney going up, dude.
Disneyland.
Disney's probably a nice hole, man.
I read a thing that said, if you volunteer for 4 hours at a vaccine site, they'll give you the vaccine.
Oh, that's something.
And I'm thinking myself, paid, do I really want to work 4 hours? I went a year without getting it. I think I'll be good.
Goodness gracious, dude.
Goodness gracious, kid.
Year of pandemicism. The pandemic has landed me a somewhat better paying job. And a whole lot better paying job in terms of free time. I don't know if they know that, but...
Same.
I enjoy it.
An apartment and a car.
Well, the come up.
Maybe not the car. Mostly the apartment.
How's your window doing?
My window?
Didn't your window get broken into?
Oh, my airbag got stolen. I got it fixed.
That's cool.
$500.
That's something.
Yeah, it's definitely it was definitely a thing.
$100? Hey. No wonder, dude, they're stealing them out of cars. That's a okay price.
Oh, the airbag was $2,000, but the insurance paid for that. But I have to pay the insurance $500.
Ah, the good old insurance, you know?
Yeah.
I got to do some insurance stuff.
All right. Let's call it quits.
Give him some last words.
Hey, guys, this is going to be my last episode.
Oh, shit.
But I hope not. I hope you listen and you subscribe. Follow me on Instagram or whatever the hell. I never post, but we'll be here on Friday with more Rick Rimbaugh.
Follow Rick Rimbaugh on Instagram. You can follow Bon Jen on Instagram. You can follow Carter Trip. But you should really, really follow Rick Rimbaugh. That's where the funnies are. That's where the lives are. We're on Clubhouse. Not on Twitch yet. So super close. Just so close. I can taste it.
So close.
You're going to want to subscribe on Twitch. Definitely. You already have Amazon Prime. So use your subscription of Amazon Prime on Rick Rimbaugh on Twitch once we get there. It'll be great. It'll kind of look like Zoom, probably, but maybe I'll do some cool aesthetic things, dude. Everybody on Instagram, thanks for watching. If you, if you're not watching on Instagram, Sundays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, put on notifications on Instagram so you know, and you don't have to remember a schedule, you know?
Bye, Tiffany. Bye.
If Alex
had Instagram.
Gonna need,
thanks
gonna
for
need
listening.
A shorter hand.
Be back. There. Please. Okay. Like us on Apple Podcasts. All right, subscribe. Goodbye.
Tell a friend. Peace.